Hi all, in this video, let's explore about React Profiler API. We use this API to measure the metrics of a component or to identify part of the component which is taking more time. So let's explore that. So this is a sample application I have taken from the Material UI. So here I will be writing the code in this. So the Profiler API is available in the React package. So firstly, we need to import that Profiler API from React package. Once we have imported that, we need to wrap the component. For which component we want to measure the metrics, or which component you feel that is taking more time, then you need to measure. You need to wrap that component in the profiler component. This a profiler component is a lightweighted component which takes two properties. Number one is the ID. So just here I'm giving as table info, and the second parameter is a callback on render. This callback takes a function. So once this component is rendered, this callback function would be called. So let me show that. So firstly, I will try to wrap this table component into the profiler. So this is how we wrapped. And now I need to write this callback function. So once we write this callback function, when this component loads, this callback function would be triggered. So I'm writing a callback function here. So this callback function takes a certain parameters. The parameters are like ID, which tells which profiler we are loading. Here we it would be like table info. And next parameter would be the face. So this tells whether the component is loading initially or it is updating. So that's that is about this phrase. And the second is actual, and the third parameter is actual time. So which tells how much time it takes to render the component. And the fourth parameter would be the base time, which will tell how much time it taken to load the entire subtree. And later on the start time, where it tells about when the React has begun this update, and also the commit time. So when the React has completed this commit, I mean this render commit. So these are the parameters will be there in the. So now I will try to console these parameters. Instead log, I will try to use the table, where I will try to print these parameters in a table. Okay. So let's check that. So once it was imported, yep. Let me refresh this. So I think we are using the same names. Okay. Let me check whether it is running or not. It is compiling. Let me check it. So usually, meanwhile, I will try to explain you the properties. This is a React official website. Here you can find the profiler API callback parameters. So we have not used the last parameter interactions. This is because interactions is an experimental, still that is in experiment mode. So these are the remaining parameters we have used in the callback function. So I think application was loaded. Let's see that. I think there is something wrong. So it's taking the last update. Yeah, let me load it again. Yeah, now it loaded. See if you observe the, I think somewhere this is rendered. So let me remove that. In the 12th line, I think it was rendered. Okay, so fine. Now the component loads. So when the component is loaded, I will go to the table component. So once I go to the table component, you can see the table mount, the phrases mount. It means it is updated. The ID is table info, and here you can find the actual time, base time, start time, and commit time. These are few metrics we can observe while the table is rendering. So let's check this. So this profiler is lightweight component. So even it is a lightweight component, it uses some of the CPU and memory utilization. So that's the reason this profiler API is not recommended in the production build. It would be disabled in the production build. So this profiler can be used in multiple places. For example, if you want to use, you want to find the metrics and of this sidebar, you can wrap this sidebar in a profiler and give a unique ID for that. And also you can use this profiler multiple times. You can also wrap this navbar and give a separate unique ID for this navbar. You can also do that. And this profiler, you can nest these profilers as well. So instead just logging that into the console, you can do a backend call, API call, and you can aggregate all these chat in performance issues in a chat as well. And that is all about this profiler API. And one more thing is like, we might have heard about this React developer tools. If we are developing React.js, we may heard about this Chrome extension React dev tools. If you search here React dev tools, we will be getting React developer tools. If you install this extension and restart your Chrome, you'll be getting two tabs here in your application. One is the components and another one is a profiler. So this profiler is built on top of this profiler API itself. This is same as such we have seen this. So this is a ranked chat, which will tell us these committed render information, those things. So this will be helpful at the point of development mode. Whereas this, what we have seen in the code part, we can log this information. So this helps, we can do this logging and measuring the metrics in the coding point of time as well. So this is all about this React Profiler API. Hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching.